In this video, we'll show you one of the best ways that we have found to send money abroad, receive funds in different currencies, and spend internationally. Wise makes it easy with no hidden fees and great exchange rates. It's our go-to method, and we'll walk you through how to sign up and use Wise so you can start sending and receiving your money today. A lot of you have asked how we transfer money internationally, so we're breaking it down step by step. We'll show you how to sign up, send money, and even use the Wise debit card. So let's get started.
The first step is signing up for Wise. We've made it super easy for you to sign up. Just use the first link in our video description. This is my personal referral link, and by using it, you'll get a free transfer for up to a certain amount. So if you want to save money on that first transfer, make sure to click that link. When you click that link, you'll land on a page that looks something like this. You'll see that you get a fee-free transfer for up to 14,000 Mexican pesos, or around $700. Since we live in Mexico, it displays the amount in pesos, but don't worry, the fee-free transfer applies to any currency you want to send. Let's create your first Wise account. Just enter the email here and click Get Your Gift. Next, choose whether you want a personal or business account. Then, select the country where you live and click Continue. On this next screen, you'll see an overview of what your Wise account can do based on your country of residence. In this example, the home country is the US. With this account, you can send money abroad, including to your own international bank account, which is the main reason why we use Wise. You can also hold and convert over 40 currencies, spend money internationally in over 200 countries, receive money from over 20 countries, and even earn interest on the money that you keep in your Wise account. You do have to opt in for that feature though. Click Continue. Now it's time to verify your phone number. The phone number does not have to be from your home country. For example, if your home country is the United States, but you carry a Mexican cell phone, you can enter that number here. Wise will use this number to send you notifications, so make sure that you use the number that you have on you most of the time. Just type it in here and click Send Verification Code. Once you receive your code, enter it here and hit Done. Now, let's create your password. Type it in and click Continue. Next, enter your legal name, birth date, and click Continue. Now, add your address. You can search by address or postal code, but if that doesn't work, click Enter Address manually and type it in yourself. Once the fields are filled out, click Continue. Next, you might see a screen asking for additional details, like your nationality. Just fill that out and click Confirm and Continue.
Because Wise follows strict security regulations, they'll ask you for identity verification. You'll need a valid form of ID, like a passport, driver's license, or national ID. Make sure to have that handy. You'll upload a clear photo of your ID and Wise will review it, sometimes instantly and other times within a couple of days. But don't worry, we'll show you that process later. For now, your account is set up and you're ready to make your first transaction.
If you're creating an account for the first time, you'll see this screen after confirming your nationality. Here, we have a choice of what you want to do first. We'll choose Send Money. Next, you have a choice of currencies the recipient can receive. Let's choose Mexican pesos. You can choose to put the exact amount that you want to send or the exact amount that you want the recipient to receive. It's up to you. In this example, we'll type the amount we want to send. Wise will automatically calculate the amount the recipient will receive. It'll instantly show you the exchange rates, fees, and estimated delivery time. You can also see here where the payment will be taken from a debit card, which you'll need to add to your account if you choose this method of payment. And if you choose to pay with a debit card, you can see the estimated processing time of 30 minutes. You can also see the estimated fees. You can see that in this case, the estimated fee is $1.20, but in this example, since we're using a new account and signed up through the referral link we mentioned earlier, the fees are being waived for transfers up to 14,000 pesos, or roughly around $700. Let's click Change. We want to link our US bank account to this account instead. Next, choose how you want to pay. Wise offers different payment options like bank transfers, debit cards, and credit cards. Some methods have lower fees than others, and you'll be able to compare them side by side once you have the different accounts connected. Let's choose Connect Bank Account. You can see here that with bank transfers, the estimated processing time is only seconds. In our experience, transfers we make from our US bank account are completed almost instantly. You can also see the estimated fees here, which remember are being waived in this transaction, but they show $1.09 versus the $1.20 we saw earlier for the transfer from a debit card. So if you were comparing transfers from your debit card versus your bank account, in this case, it would be cheaper to do it from your bank account. Now click Add Recipient. The easiest way to transfer money using Wise is to transfer to someone with a Wise account. If you have a bank account in another country, this is what you'll choose to transfer money to your bank account. To transfer to another Wise user, simply type their unique Wise handle, which Wise calls Wise Tag, and select the user once they appear. Otherwise, you have two options. One, you can transfer to somebody else's foreign bank account. It's noon, everyone. Hear the bells? You'll need their bank transfer information, which you can enter here. This varies from country to country, and it can be tricky to understand sometimes. Or two, you can choose to let Wise reach out to the recipient via email so they can input their information themselves in a secure online form to complete the transfer. For this example, though, we'll choose the first option and search for someone with a Wise account. Once it appears, we simply click on it. If this is your first transaction, you'll see this screen, which is just a short questionnaire. Just go through it as best as you can. It's just for Wise to better understand how people are using their platform, but it won't affect your transfer. All right, we're almost there. Before confirming, double check all the details. If everything looks good, check the box next to I accept the terms of use and hit continue to payment. If this is your first transaction, you'll see this window pop up where you can read through the terms of use. Once you're satisfied with the terms, scroll all the way to the bottom and click I agree. All right, since this is our first transaction, we do have to connect our US bank account to it. In your case, you'd connect your local bank account to it. Click on Instant Verification. Wise uses a service called Plaid to connect your account. Click Continue. If you see your bank here, you can choose it by clicking on it. If not, like in our case, search for your bank above. Just start typing a few characters of your bank's name, and once it pops up, click on it to select it. Now check the box indicating that you are human. Next, click Continue to log in to connect to your bank account. If you have multiple accounts, like a checking and a savings account, for example, choose the one that you want to withdraw from and click Continue. Click Continue again. We're almost done, I promise. We've heard that one before, I know. Now, to choose the account that you just connected, click Pay. You'll receive a confirmation email and you can track your transfer in real time. Now, as a security measure, Wise will ask you to enter your Wise password. Go ahead and enter it here, then click Done. Wise will send you a security code to the phone number that you added to your account. I believe this only happens a few times in the beginning, every time you try to do a transfer, but after a while, it gets to know your device and we'll stop asking for that. Anyway, once you receive the code, enter it here, and now click Done. You can see that the transaction has been paused. Click Fix Your Transfer. You are going to have to provide a little bit more information to prove that it is you doing this transaction. If you're using a US bank account, Wise will ask you for your social security number or your ITIN for compliance. In this example, since it is a US account and we have a social security number, we have to provide it. If we didn't have a social security number, then you would have to submit other forms of ID. Let's go ahead and provide the social security number now. Click Enter My SSN or ITIN, enter the number here, and click Continue. Now you'll get a link to continue identity identification on your phone. Grab your smartphone if you have one, and if you don't have one, just click Send a link by email. For the purposes of this example, we'll use our phone. We'll click on Scan a QR code. Let's grab the phone and scan the QR code. When you do this, you'll be asked to use your phone's camera to take a picture of your ID. And it can be a US issued driver's license or your passport. And then after that, you'll have to do a selfie. Do that now. Okay, now we're really almost done. Click on Close.
And that's it. Wise will notify you once the money reaches the recipient. In this example, it was instantaneous.
Now let's look at how to use the Wise multi-currency account.
One of Wise's most powerful features is the multi-currency account. You can hold balances in over 40 countries and switch between them at the real mid-market exchange rate with no hidden fees. You'll also get local bank account details for several major currencies, which lets you receive payments like a local in countries like the US, the UK, Eurozone, Australia, and more. This is perfect if you work with international clients, get paid in different currencies, or travel often. But what about spending that money? That's where the Wise debit card comes in.
If eligible, you can order a Wise debit card right from the app or website. Once it arrives, just activate it in the app and set your PIN, security settings, and spending limits.
Before you start using the card, be sure to add money to your Wise account. You can do this by transferring from your bank or receiving payments into one of your Wise currency balances.
Once you're set up, you can use the Wise card to pay online, in stores, or withdraw cash from ATMs worldwide, always at the real exchange rate with no hidden markups. Just remember, some fees may apply if you go over certain withdrawal limits.
And just like that, you're ready to spend globally without worrying about bad exchange rates or high bank fees. Here are a few pro tips to get the most out of Wise. Number one, compare payment methods. Some have lower fees than others. Number two, enable two-factor authentication. Keep your account secure. Number three, use Wise for international payments. It's way cheaper than traditional bank transfers. And number four, check exchange rates before sending money. Wise updates rates in real time. If you're new here, we're Antonieta and Francisco, and we share our journey of international living, travel, and everything in between. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments and we'd love to help. And if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you never miss a tutorial like this.
Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.
Bye, everybody.